So my take on this, today we're looking at the perfect and pluperfect subjunctive. Now remember, the subjunctive mood is used in place of the indicative, especially in subordinate clauses, as well as to show, as in conditionals we'll see later on, and also volitive, hortatory, potential type constructions, even a thing called an optative, a wishing, would that this be so. It's not as definite, of course, than indicative. And the question always people ask me, Mr. Davis, how do you translate the subjunctive? Well, when you translate the subjunctive, always translate it just normally, unless the construction dictates that it should not be that way, i.e., it's a hortatory. You don't, when you say, you know, amemos, let us love, you translate it as a volitive or a hortatory, and you don't translate it to say we love. But with the perfect subjunctives and then the pluperfect subjunctives as well, often these guys are translated normally because it's in like a cum clause, which you guys will be learning about, which is that it basically shows time, when something happened. It can also show some other type of meanings as well. But use translating normally. So if you look here at the perfect subjunctive, you would just most of the time translate as I loved or I have loved. I keperem, I took, I have taken. Okay? Now the question people have, the thing we're focusing on, is how do you form this? Well, the perfect subjunctive, like all in the active, you always use what principal part? You always use the third principal part. So you always take the third principal part, and then you add to the stem, you chop off the I to get the perfect stem, and then you add erim, eris, erit, erimus, eritus, erit. Now you'll notice this looks very much similar to, it looks very similar to the future perfect, all right? And it is exactly the same, except for the first one, for the future perfect, would be ero, okay? So sometimes you have to look into context to see if it's a future perfect or is it just perfect, okay? Now, it's always the same. It doesn't matter on the conjugation. You just take the third principal part. So for capio, capere, capio, capere, capi. So it'd be caperem, caperis, caperit, caperimus, caperitus, caperet, like that, all right? And then for the passive, it's a motus. You just take the fourth principal part, and then you use the present form of sum. Instead of sum, you say sim. So you go amatis sim, amatis sis, amatis sit, amati simus, amati sistis, amati sit. Now, of course, you can change the endings here of the perfect passive participle just according to what the subject is. You know, you can make it, of course, into feminine or neuter depending on what the subject. All right? And it's the same thing here. Coptu sim, coptu sis, coptu sit, simus, sitis, sit. So that's just the perfect. It's very straightforward. It works for all conjugations, and it's not that big of a deal. All right, pluperfect again is a little bit different, but again it's the same for all conjugations. So what you do with this is you take the perfect infinitive, and the perfect infinitive is just the third principal part, and this is for the active, of course. Third principal part plus esse, okay? And you go ama wisem, and you take the infinitive and just add the endings. M, S, T, mus, tis, nt. So ama wisem, ama wises, ama wiset, ama wisemus, ama wisetis, ama set. And then for the pluperfect here, for the capio again, it would be capissem. You just take the third principal part, add I-S-S-E, and then M-S-T. So you pick the perfect infinitive and add the endings. Okay? Now for the passive, and I'll go ahead, if you need to get this, I can just always go back on the video, the beautiful thing about the video here. Now for the pluperfect subjunctive passive, what we do here, I'll put the passive right here, all you do is you just take, and I'll use black pen again, you take the fourth principal part, because it's perfect and it's passive, like the all-perfect system. So you take the fourth principal part, amatus, okay, amatus, matus, and then instead of using the present form of the subjunctive of sum, you use the imperfect form. That's correct. So it's sm, ss, set, and then for the plural, You know, you just make a mati, a mati, a mati, be asset, asemus, asetus, asset, like that. All right. And then for capio, what would be the fourth principal part of capio? Yeah, it would be coptus again. All right, so you take the fourth principal part, coptus. That's the same thing, coptus sm, coptus ss, coptus set, and then copti semus, copti setus, copti ascent, like so. And there we go. So that's how you form the perfect and pluperfect subjunctive. All right. Olete omnes, lingua latina est vita.